Senator Patty Murray from the great state of Washington has been in office since 1993. That's a really long time. Just for the record, that's when my bar mitzvah was. That's how long ago it was, and I just had a milestone birthday that wasn't 30. Okay? It's been a really, really long time that she's been in office. Joining us now on the Genuine Auto Glass studio line is her challenger, one of the most organized, best-funded challengers I've seen to her in quite some time. Tiffany Smiley, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you, Ari, for having me on. Happy to be with you today.
My absolute pleasure. So tell me, what are your top three issues, top three things that you want to do the day you get elected to Senate? These are the top three things you want to slap your name on these bills. What are they?
Look, I am a mom, so I'm going to look at education reform in our state and how we can make it better for our children. There were so many kids in the state who had no access to broadband internet, and our children suffered over this last year during the pandemic. I'm a nurse. So I want the families of Washington State to have access to quality care it's been a failure. These two actually are education and healthcare is what Patty Murray's been running on for the last 30 years. So it is time for something new, for lower costs, free market approaches. Also, we're small business owners, and every day I'm talking to families and business owners who have been struggling. So, look, increased taxes and government overreach and control is not our future. It is destroying our beautiful state, and I am ready to be a voice for the people of Washington State.
Now, I've been looking into your history, and it's fascinating to me. I didn't know all this that happened with your husband. I didn't know all this going in. I just saw that you were running for office, and I'm like, I'd love to have her on the show. And then when I started doing my research, I was kind of blown away by your story. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so 16 years ago this month, I was working as an urgent care nurse here in Washington State. And I received a phone call, a phone call that all military spouses dread, that my husband had come face to face with a suicide car bomber while serving in Mosul, Iraq, serving our country as a first lieutenant in the United States Army. I did two things that day that I got the call. I resigned from my nursing job, and I took a one-way ticket out to Walter Reed Army Medical Center in Washington, D.C. to meet my husband there. I didn't even know if he was going to show up alive. One thing was certain is that he didn't have any eyes. He didn't just lose his eyesight. He had no eyes. And I walked into his room every single day and spoke truth and hope and life and thought for our future. I went from being an advocate and nurse for many patients to being an advocate for my husband. But one thing I knew is I wasn't just fighting for him. I was fighting for thousands of families like ours. And shortly after, I had walked in and told my husband he would never see again. I was brought into a room with military officials and VA officials and told to sign his medical paperwork to retire him from the military. I said no. I don't think they didn't know the farm girl from Pasco, Washington. They didn't know what they were up against. The doctor pushed it in front of me a little bit further, and he said, "Mrs. Smiley, I don't think you understand. There's never someone blind to continue service to our country, sign the paperwork." And I said no. So it gave me time to build a coalition of people that believed in the vision, believed in Scotty fully recovering and making that choice. And Scotty would go on to become the first blind active duty officer to continue service to our country. But I continued our fight because we also eventually, after a decade of service to our country, we had to transition into the VA. And I saw so much red tape and bureaucratic processes that were just so ineffective. And so I took our fight all the way to the White House to fight VA reform. People told me, "You're wasting your time. What are you doing, Tiffany?" And we won. So I am fighting for our children's future. I we have three beautiful boys that have been born all over the United States during our military service, and I want them to have a country worth losing their eyesight for. And that's why I'm standing up to be a voice for others in this state.
You know, I got to say, that's that just pulls at my heartstrings, that kind of story. My family's a military story, and thank you for sharing it with us. I mean, thank you for sharing it with everybody you're running with. That's something that's amazing to me. So being that you have this kind of connection with the military, being that you fought for Veterans Affairs before, what's something you could do on the national level as a senator in terms of reforming the VA, in terms of helping out with that kind of stuff? What's something clear and concrete that you experienced that you said, no, this has to stop or this needs to be changed, that you want to change at the national level?
Yes, one of the things I noticed was just how out of date, all of the VA, just the technology and the access to resources. And here we're at war, right? We're now in the longest war that we've had in this country. And we, granted it was 2005, so sort of the beginning of it, but there's all these young men and women, right, who still have their whole lives ahead of them. And they were coming back to a system that was not prepared for them. So how I see it is, if we're going to send people to war, let's make sure that we have the funding, the access, and the resources to give them the best life and the best opportunity that American can give them if they're injured when they come back.
That's nice. I like that. I mean, I think that one of the things we don't do is enough for our veterans. And I know that from my family history. I'm very lucky that my grandfather himself, he got a very successful career afterwards, and he didn't have to rely on the VA. But so many of our veterans are not able to. Right, exactly. Right.
Yes.
And so that's something that's, that sounds like something that's perfect, right up your alley. What other items are a high priority for you outside of the VA? Is there anything else that you go, this is something that really irks me and that's going to be at the top of my list to get through?
Look, the economy and our small businesses, we cannot keep overreaching and pushing down and, bringing more regulation. We need our people to flourish here. And our small businesses are the backbone of this state. So I want to see people thriving here. I want to, cut back the government control, look to free market approaches. We have so many brilliant people here in Washington State, and it's time that we had empowered people and not an empowered government, because it's hurting us from the ground level. There's a groundswell of people who are ready for something different, and we have to have something different to go forward. And so I look forward to, jobs. We need to provide good jobs, sustainable jobs, and empower our small business owners in this state.
If you're just joining us, we are talking with Tiffany Smiley, who is challenging Patty Murray for her Senate seat. Since we're not going to get term limits anytime soon, this is the best way to get a new senator in that position. Now, I want to ask you a personal question, which you probably haven't been asked before. Something that really bothers me personally, especially because I'm from a Navy family, is when I see people kneeling for the flag across the country. And that's something that really bothers me, especially in sports and such. But for me, speaking to you, somebody who lost so much, your husband lost so much, gave so much for this country, if your kids want to sign up for the military tomorrow, would you say that was okay? Would you send them? Would you say happily, yes, go?
Look, listen, our boys at a young age knew exactly why their dad was blinded by another human being who their father looked in the eyes and tried to kill him. They know that a bomb took their father's eyes. So that's why they can't throw a football with him. He'll never drive them. He'll never see their faces. But what they also know is the power of forgiveness and the power of being able to release any hatred or anger that you would have towards another human being. So our boys are, they've had to comprehend that from a very young age, and that we love this country. This country is the best country in the world. So our family will always stand for that flag. We lost greatly. We have skin in the game for this country. And this country also gave us the opportunity to stand up to the government and do something that had never been done before. Scotty continuing on active duty. Me continuing, being able to continue to work remotely and fight for my children's future. That doesn't happen in other countries. So our family will always stand for that flag.
That's amazing.
And I want my boys to serve. I want my boys to serve this great country. They know that it's not for free. Every single day, they're reminded because their father cannot see.
That's beautiful. If people want to volunteer for your campaign, if people want to donate to your campaign, if people just want to meet you, what's the best way for them to get in touch with you?
Come get involved. I am ready to send a very, very loud message from Washington State all the way to Washington, D.C., that the people here are ready for common sense solutions and to ready to be the the grassroots effort that changes the trajectory of this state. So join me, join us. I want to meet you. I want to hear from everyone. I want to learn from people in this state. So join us at Smiley for Washington, and it's all spelled out. So Washington is spelled out. SmileyForWashington.com. Come get involved, volunteer, share your voice, meet us at events. We're going to have smaller events coming up when it's safe and appropriate, but we can engage online. Join us on our social media, and I cannot wait to get out there and meet the incredible people of this state.
Tiffany Smiley for the U.S. Senate. You can find her at SmileyForWashington.com. Thank you so much for joining us today, and best of luck with your campaign.
Thank you, Ari. I really appreciate it. Hope to be back on.
All right. Anytime.